In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can use the sweep feature in Autodesk Inventor. For the sweep feature, we need two things. We need a path and a profile to sweep along that path. So I have a few different examples of some paths already created here. So in each case, I will just need to go ahead and create my profile. The profile needs to be perpendicular to the endpoint of the path. Often this will coincide with an origin plane or a work plane. In this particular example, my YZ plane coincides with these endpoints, so I'm going to sketch on it. Then, if necessary, I'm going to project the geometry of the endpoint here. This particular one is already at the origin, so there's already a point there. So I'll just go ahead and draw my circular shape now. I'm drawing a circular shape. It, of course, could be any sort of shape that you want here. But to keep it simple, I'll use a circular shape here with a quarter inch diameter. So I now have a path and a profile perpendicular to the endpoint of the path. Next, I'll choose my sweep tool. Now, if you only have one path and one profile, it'll automatically select them in most cases. But here I've got multiple shapes, so I'll have to select. So first, my profile, that's going to be this circular shape. Then my path. As you can see, it doesn't automatically switch to that tool because you could potentially select more than one profile. So I'll select my path tool here, then select the path to project it along. Now, one of the options I want to look at here is my orientation. By default, it is set to follow the path. So basically, the profile is going to be normal to or perpendicular to the path at any location. I'm going to share that sketch so I can use it again. And then I'll make another example, very similar, but this time I'm going to choose the parallel option. So once more, I will sketch on the plane here. This time I need to project that endpoint because there's not already a point there. Then once more, I'll go ahead and draw a circle with a quarter inch diameter. Then I'll begin my sweep tool, select my profile, select the path button, and then the path itself. This time I'm going to switch it to the fixed option. With the fixed option, the profile is always going to stay at the same orientation as the original sketch. So you can see the result here. At any given cross section, I'm going to have the 0.25 diameter circle. So as a result, the angled shape is a little thinner than the original one here. And then of course the end is parallel to the original shape as well. These could go around curves and around 90 degree corners as well. So I could sketch on the work plane again here. And then this time I'll do one more. I'll project the geometry of the endpoint, draw in my circular shape, and then I can sweep. Profile, path. As you can see with this particular one, I can't possibly use the fixed option because it can't be parallel to the original face and go up this 90 degree angle. So I need to switch this back to the fixed option. And again, you can see the end result there. So as I mentioned, I can go around curves as well. So we'll do another sketch here. And then once more, I'm going to project the geometry of that endpoint. This time I'll create a rectangular shape. Let's say it's going to be 1 by 0.5. There we go. And then I'll go ahead and sweep it. Path. And then click OK. Next, we'll look at an example where I don't already have a work plane that I can use. So here I have a curve. I want to create a sweep along that path, but I do not have a work plane anymore that I can sketch on like I did in these previous examples. So I need to create my own work plane. The tool for this is here in the work features panel. You can actually just hit the regular plane tool, but if I want to get more specific, I can click the drop down and see the very last option, normal to a curve at a point. So basically you just need to click on a curve or a line and then its endpoint, and it will create a plane for you. So I'll choose the curve, and then the endpoint, and you can see that Inventor constructed a normal plane there. So now once more I can sketch on this shape. I can project geometry of that endpoint, create my shape, and then sweep it along that path. So again, very easy to construct a work plane for that. Then let's look at a couple more options to finish up our discussion on sweeps, and that is being able to taper the shape and also twist it. I'll go ahead and start my sketch, but I'm going to need a work plane first because I don't think this coincides with my original work plane here. So once again, I'll use the plane tool, select the line and its endpoint. You can see it works just the same for a line as it does a curve. I'll go ahead and sketch on this plane. And then I'll project the geometry of that endpoint. And then I'll do something different. I'll make a polygon this time. Go with six sides here. Create a shape. I'll come back in and add a couple of constraints here to finish this up. And then a dimension across it. We'll say half an inch here. Okay, so I'll go ahead and use my sweep tool again here. Choose my path. And then I can use the taper and twist section here. So if I want to have it get larger or smaller as it's swept, I can increase the taper angle as you can see here. Just like with an extrusion, but obviously it can follow a curve or multiple shapes here. And then I can also twist it. So if I were to twist it 180 degrees, then from the original sketch along this path, it's going to twist the shape 180 degrees for me. So there you can see the end result there. So pretty complex shape with two simple profiles. We'll actually look at one more thing, and that's the ability to cut while doing a sweep. Just like with extrusions and revolves, you can add material, cut material out, or you can use the intersection of two features as well. So here I've already got some planes set up. I'm going to sketch on this work plane here, and then I am going to project the geometry of the shape. I'm going to use this as my path. Then I will go ahead and sketch on the other work plane here, and then I will project the geometry of the line as it crosses through here so I can get a point. Then I will make a circle. So now I have my profile and my path. So I'll go ahead and use my sweep tool, select my profile, then my path. And then we'll look at the different options here. So the default option is to join. So if I use that option, then I'm going to get the added material there. I'll edit my sweep and change this to cut. I'll click OK. And there you can see that it cut the material out instead. And I can even use the intersection option. There it's only going to keep the material unique to those two features. And then, of course, I have the ability to create a new solid body as well if I want to do that option. I'll go ahead and return this to cut. So once again, for a sweep, you just simply need a path, which could be a straight line, it could be curves, it could be a series of segments. And then you just need a profile that is sketched at one of the endpoints of that path. That concludes this look at creating swept features in Autodesk Inventor.